What's going on, family? I'm Scrapbook Boxing, Museum of the Forgotten Fistic of Series. We're going to continue examining 100 years of world championship fights. Right now, we're looking at Rocky Graziano and Tony Zale, 1948. What a fight that was. The closest fight that I personally went to was Thomas Hearns and Marvin Hagler in 1985. So let's take a look at Tony Zale and Rocky Graziano.
Graziano has youth on his side. He's only 26. Zale is 34. Rocky's been installed the favorite, 2-1. Graziano from a knockout. Round three.
Now, September 21st, 1948, NBA world middleweight champion Tony Zale gets knocked out by Marcel Sedan in front of 19,272 spectators. Now, collectively, they paid $242,840 to watch Sedan drop Tony Zale with a left hook. And he was stopped in the 11th round as referee Paul Cavalier grabs Tony Zale as he was melting to the canvas. The fight took place at Old Roosevelt Stadium in Jersey City, New Jersey. Now, Tony Zale was 35 years old. He stood 5'7.5". He weighed 159 pounds and had a 69-inch reach. He had a record of 107 wins, 3 losses, and 62 knockouts. As for Marcel Sedan, he was a younger fighter at 32 years old. He stood 5'6.5". He weighed 158 pounds and he had a 69-inch reach. He had a record of 67 wins, 17 losses, 2 draws, and 45 knockouts. Now, Marcel Sedan was a very strong puncher. And Tony Zale was originally supposed to face Charlie Burley. But he skipped over Charlie Burley and gave Marcel Sedan a chance. You see, Charlie Burley was ranked number 2, and Jake LaMotta was ranked number 1. But Jake LaMotta was tied up at the moment. And the next logical contender would have been Charlie Burley. But he chose Marcel Sedan instead and was knocked out in the 11th round. So let's quickly take a look at that fight between Marcel Sedan and world middleweight champion from Gary, Indiana, Tony Zale.
Once again, you've got to say the punch rate here from Sedan is so much higher than Zale's, and of course, most on target. He did miss a wee bit in the 7th round. Bashes away with the left hook. Both men wearing 8-ounce horsehair filled boxing gloves. And over the course of a long fight, these gloves do break up. Left hook again from Sedan. Well, you can see why he's nicknamed the Casablanca Clouter. This man can hit. Say Sedan must be wondering what on earth is keeping Zale upright. And once again, Sedan almost threatening to walk through Zale here. Oh, beautiful. Beautiful left hook here from the Frenchman. Well, Sedan has obviously been frustrated by the holding tactics of Tony Zale throughout this fight. But I think Zale's... Oh, he's got him with a lovely left hook there. Zale on his knees in round 11.
So Marcel Sedan knocks out Tony Zale in the 11th round. 1948, he becomes the brand new middleweight champion of the world. And he would next take on the Bronx Bull, Jake LaMotta. Referee Paul Cavalier was a trainer of mine at Lenny Shaw's boxing gym. He has to rescue Tony Zale as he melts in his arms before falling to his face in Newark, New Jersey. Let's move on to more championship fights. September 23rd, 1948, World Welterweight Champion Ray Robinson defeats the Cuban Hawk, Kid Gavilan, 10 rounds in New York's Yankee Stadium. Now, who was Kid Gavilan? His name was Geraldo Gonzalez. They called him the Cuban Hawk. He was born January 6, 1926 in Cuba. He had a record of 143 total bouts, 108 wins, 28 knockouts, 30 losses and 5 draws. Akib Gavilan died February 13, 2003. He was 77 years of age at the time of his death. He would reside in Miami, Florida. But he'd be buried in Havana, Cuba. Now, I had the pleasure of meeting Kid Gavilan. January 11th, 1949. Ray Robinson, once again, defeat Kid Gavilan. This time at the Municipal Stadium in Philadelphia, Pennsylvania. Ray's fourth title defense. He would receive 40% of the gate. $128,435. Kid Gavilan would receive 18% of the gate. Robinson was a 2-1 favorite. $175,754 would be the gross gate. Kid Gavilan, Sugar Ray Robinson. What a hell of a fight that was. Kid Gavilan is to your left and Ray Robinson is to your right. Now, Kid Gavilan was inspired by Kid Chocolate. It was also inspired by Cefnino Garcia because Kid Gavilan threw a beautiful bolo punch. But he was a little bit different than Cefnino Garcia's because Kid Gavilan would do a double bolo punch, swing over his head and under his waistline. He would learn from chopping down sugar canes in Cuba with a machete. Beautiful fighter, very fast with his hands, was Kid Gavilan. Thank you. Ray Robinson would face Kid Gavilan. It would be his 99th professional fight. And boy, would he put on a show. Kid Gavilan would show the world that he would be a force to be reckoned with. And when Ray Robinson would give up his title, 1950, to chase Jake LaMotta's middleweight championship belt. At that time, Marcel Cerdan was the force to be reckoned with. Kid Gavilan would face Johnny Bratton for the NBA welterweight championship belt. Now, Johnny Bratton would take the title away from Charlie Fusari, who didn't have the title. The title was vacant at that time. And Charlie Fusari and Johnny Bratton would fight for the vacant crown. And Johnny Bratton would win the title. And Kid Gavilan would defeat Johnny Bratton for the NBA welterweight championship crown. Now this is the great Cuban Kid Gavilan, Cuban Hawk. I'm going to end this video with a tribute, a final tribute to Henry Armstrong. Kid Gavilan was a hell of a fighter. When we get to the fight with him and Gil Turner, 1952. That was a hell of a fight. Shout out to Kid Gavilan. Henry Armstrong becoming the featherweight champion. 1937, when he defeated Petey Cerrone, New York's Madison Square Garden. Armstrong would be the first Black American featherweight champion in boxing history. Henry would then move up to the welterweight division, and he would capture that title from Barney Ross, New York's Madison Square Garden Bowl, 15 rounds. He would now hold two world lineal titles, featherweight and a welterweight championship. Armstrong would then move down to the lightweight division and capture that title from Lou Ambers, same year, 1938. And he would hold three world lineal titles, the featherweight, welterweight, and lightweight championship belts. After giving up the featherweight championship belt, Henry Armstrong would lose his title as a welterweight, 1940, to Fizzy Zivic, October 4th, 15 rounds. Armstrong last shot at stardom be in 1940. Before he would lose his crown to Fitzgerald, he would move up to the middleweight division and face Cefrino Garcia, man who he defeated in 1938. He'd be robbed. 10-round draw after having 5 rounds taken away from him. Incredible. Armstrong would lose his lightweight championship belt to Lou Ambrose.